An Iraq War veteran and Democratic representative from that great state of Hawaii, Tulsi Gabbard, joins us. Nice to see
Aloha,
you.
Aloha, Greta.
Aloha. So why won't the president say Islamic extremism?
Oh, the first thing I think we've got to understand that this is not just about words. It's not just about semantics. It's really about having a real, true understanding of who our enemy is and how important that is, that we have to understand what their motivation is and what their ideology. It's this radical Islamic ideology that's fueling them. Just a couple days ago, Secretary Kerry said in a speech that ISIS and Al-Qaeda are engaging in, quote, criminal conduct rooted in alienation, poverty, thrill-seeking, and other factors. Now, if we really look at what he's saying, and if that's really the cause, then the solution would be just to give them a trophy, give them a hug, give them a good-paying job, $10,000, and a skateboard so they can go and get their thrills and say, okay, great, they're going to be happy and they won't be fighting anymore. That's not the case. Unfortunately, we have people who are living in poverty all around the world, people who have this same feeling of alienation from their government, but they're not terrorists. So we've got to look at what their ideology is and how that's fueling these tragic attacks that keep occurring.
All right. Do you think that your strong view on this is because you actually went to Iraq and you've actually seen it? I mean, the rest of us, including President Obama, Secretary Kerry, we were sort of on the sidelines looking at it. You were actually there.
Yes, it does. And it comes from experiencing not only the culture, myself personally, but also seeing the incredibly high cost of war, seeing friends of mine who did not make it home, people who I served with in Iraq, and unfortunately the countless other lives who sacrificed and paid that ultimate price.
So do you think when the president won't say Islamic extremism that he doesn't really know who the enemy is? Is that it? There he has it. I mean, I don't get this one.
Well, I think, in my opinion, it really is not recognizing that Islamic extremism is the enemy. And we can see that through their actions, through the decisions that this administration has made. And Libya is a perfect example, where if you don't know who your enemy is, you end up going to war with people who are not your enemy. In Libya, we had a situation where Gaddafi was taken out. We attacked Libya, and we look now, rather than eliminating our enemy, these Islamic extremists, they're stronger there now than they were before. And there are other examples. We look at the proposed attacks on Syria that occurred just over a year ago. Again, we're dealing with a situation where this is not our enemy. This is not the people who are threatening the American people.
So it really, so this isn't just a spat between a lot of Republicans, and of course you share the view, the word game. This is a real problem, a real failure to confront who the enemy is.
It's a real problem because of a very simple reason, actually, and that is something I learned is military 101, but something that's easy for everyone to understand, and that is if you are at war, which we are, you have to know who your enemy is in order to defeat them. You've got to recognize what's fueling them, what's motivating them, what are their strategies and tactics that they're using in order to be able to defeat them and prevent them from attacking the American people.
Congresswoman, nice to see you. And of course, thank you for your service, because like I said, you were there. The rest of us weren't. Thank you.
Thank you, Greta. Aloha.